President Marcos won't be naming a new education secretary anytime soon, saying he needs more time to make that decision. The president says he is looking for someone who can bring up the test scores in the country. This comes after the Philippines ranked poorly in a recent international assessment testing the creative thinking of students. Marcos adds he doesn't have a short list of candidates since they are looking at everyone to find the right person for the job. Marcos earlier vowed to name within the week his choice to replace Vice President Sara Duterte, whose resignation takes effect on July 19.
It turns out it's harder than I thought. So because we have to absolutely get it right. We have to see really what the DepEd needs. I've gone through so many CVs. Marami tayong magagaling. We have to choose somebody who has an understanding of what is important in terms of being an educator. The same person also has to have those qualities that they can galvanize this very, very large bureaucracy, which is the DepEd.
Meantime, an education advocate, the Philippine Business for Education, listed four individuals they believe can be the next education chief. They've recommended Senator Sonny Angara, Social Welfare Secretary Rex Gatchalian, Negros Occidental Representative Jose Francisco Benitez, and education advocate Milwida Guevara to lead the education portfolio. DBED says the four leaders are exceptional and well-immersed in the education sector. A Chinese national believed to be one of the big bosses operating illegal pogo hubs was caught by authorities in one of the villas in Fontana Leisure Park in Pampanga. Now, Zian Ambrosio reports.
Combined law enforcement agents swooped down the Fontana Leisure Park in Pampanga Thursday night. Elements from the PNP Special Action Force, Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, and the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group raided several villas searching for a high-value target, said to be the big boss of the illegal pogo hubs in Bamban, Tarlac, and Porac, Pampanga. Only one Chinese national was arrested in the operation, suspected to be the manager of Zunyuan Technology, which is behind the raided offshore gaming firm in Tarlac. Authorities suspect many of their targets were able to flee before they arrived.
He's now being questioned or investigated by the PAOP and the CIDG. That is one of the informations that reached us. The other was they were able to escape Porac and they proceeded in these villas.
Siguro baka natunugan din nila yung pagpasok natin. At least na nagkakaroon na ng muka. Dati kasi walang mga muka itong mga to eh. Alam natin na tumatakbo yung isang illegal pogo hub and yet di natin alam kung sino yung nagpapatakbo.
18 vaults were seized from the five villas, including important documents containing the names of Wang Jiang and Zhang Rujin, who are believed to be the business partners of suspended Bamban, Tarlac Mayor Alice Guo. Also arrested in the raid are a former police officer who worked as the group's driver, an interpreter, and a security guard. According to the investigation of the Anti-Crime Commission, the Filipino driver is a security officer of Guo and the family of Wang Ziyang. He denies the accusation.
Ay, hindi ko po kilala yun. Napapanood ko po siya, pero hindi ko po siya kilala.
Senator Risa Ontiveros believes the pogo hubs in Tarlac and Pampanga are connected and operated by the same network of handlers.
Posibleng tignan din po namin iyan sa pagkompleto ng aming investigasyon sa POGOs and dun sa binanggit nyo ngang biggest money laundering case sa Singapore na dawit ang dalawang kasosyo ni Mayor Alice Guo.
The provincial government of Pampanga has expressed alarm over this development since the economic zone of the province is being exploited as a safe house.
That is something which should be looked into kasi this is a serious matter. Merong portion dun sa economic zone natin na merong mga villa doon apparently serving as a haven for criminals.
Hindi po namin tinotolerate dito yan. Aware po kami na maraming foreigner dyan. Kaya nga po nagipag-coordinate kami sa CDC para mag-conduct ng inspection sana.
According to the Clark Development Corporation, Fontana will continue to operate as authorities conduct their investigation. Zian Ambrosio, ABS-CBN News, Pampanga.
The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission warns against foreigners buying up land in the Philippines. PAOK says this threatens the country's food security as the foreigners would rent farmlands in key agriculture provinces for around 100,000 pesos per hectare. Irats, Palawan, and Nueva Ecija are among the provinces where this is happening. The anti-crime body says it will coordinate with the agriculture and interior departments to address these issues.
Let's say, yung mga dayuhan po na yon eh, magtanim po ng bigas. Kung lahat po ng pinagtataniman po natin ng bigas, inuupahan po nila. Sila na po yung magkocontrol ng presyo ng bigas. Medyo nakakatakot din po yon.
More impending legal woes for embattled Bamban Mayor Alice Go. The Philippine poll body plans to join the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission in a filing of a case against Go, this time for allegedly misrepresenting herself as a Filipino citizen when she filed her candidacy in 2022. The National Bureau of Investigation earlier revealed the fingerprints of Go and Chinese national Go Huaping are identical, making them the same person.
Ang COMELEC naman, pwede po kami magboto proprio file ng kasong kriminal o election offense sa pamamagitan ng aming law department. Kapagkat lalo pa, kung merong pong misrepresentasyon o pagsisinungaling sa Certificate of Candidacy. Tatandaan po natin na ang Certificate of Candidacy ay under oath pinapanumpaan. At kahit nga walang requirement ng additional document, naniniwala ang batas, ang COMELEC, na magkakaroon ng tunay na deklarasyon ng mga kandidato kapagkat ito po'y pinanumpaan nila.
Despite revelations on Go's identity, her lawyer insists on her innocence.
Ina-expect ko na gagamitin nila yan sa legal forum. That will only be the best time for us to confront them. The respondent is still entitled to the presumption of innocence. Kasi right now, well, she's still innocent. Ano? Yan naman ang ating batas.
The Philippines' Office of the Solicitor General now preparing petitions to cancel the birth certificate of embattled Mayor Alice Go. This is according to the Philippine Statistics Bureau, which recommended the cancellation. Despite this, Go's records will still be retained in the civil registry but will not be reissued.
Ang proseso dyan, sir, ay ang OSG po ang magsasampa ng petisyon, magfa-file ng petisyon sa ating mga korte. Hindi po basta-basta na matanggal po natin ang record sa civil registry database, both sa local civil registry office at sa national civil registry database na hinahawakan ng PSA. Technically, tatanggalin na po yung birth certificate. Although, ito po ay lahat naman po ng civil registry document ay nandoon pa rin. Pero hindi na po ito mai-issue.
The Philippines determined to boost its military capabilities amid China's escalatory actions in the West Philippines Sea. Now, on Friday, National Security Advisor Eduardo Año told personnel of the Coast Guard's Melchora Aquino that Manila is progressively building the country's defense capabilities following the June 17 Ayungin Shoal encounter that injured several Navy personnel. However, Año also stressed the Philippines will continue to seek dialogue and diplomacy to defuse tensions.
As a sovereign state, it is our duty as well as to upgrade our readiness and capabilities to assert our rights and push back against all illegal, coercive, aggressive, and deceptive tactics.
The Foreign Affairs Department earlier said Manila and Beijing are set to convene the bilateral consultation mechanism on the South China Sea in early July to discuss recent violent incidents in disputed waters. The Philippine House Panel on Human Rights defends its inquiry into alleged extrajudicial killings during the Duterte administration's deadly war on drugs. Committee Chairman Bienvenido Abante argues their inquiry is in aid of legislation. The lawmaker adds both former President Duterte and former police chief and now Senator Ronald De La Rosa should take the opportunity to face the families of the drug war victims. Bienvenido also pointed out their hearings revealed some of the police officers were unaware or unfamiliar with the government's Oplan double barrel or the PNP's anti-drug campaign.
He's a senator. He should know. we might not have the authority to investigate and charge criminal charges. But the lower house has the authority, according to our rules, to investigate in aid of legislation. He should know that there were human rights violations. When we investigated some of the police people who are just PO1, SPO1, for example, they just followed orders. They didn't even understand what double barrel means. They didn't even know what the tokhang means. They just obeyed the instructions given to them. And also, nakita rin namin na that there is allegedly a quota system during the time, you know. And we are going to go into that more as we have another hearing.
On more news, oil prices seen heading higher for the third straight week. SMHO gasoline could see the biggest jump of 1 peso per liter in the first week of July, while diesel could go up by as much as 70 centavos. As for kerosene, prices are expected to rise by at least 30 centavos. The top concern of business executives here in the Philippines is the disruption brought by artificial intelligence. A survey ran by professional services firm PwC revealed AI topped climate change and geopolitical tensions as the main concern of CEOs in the country. The firm says chief executives are concerned on how their businesses can keep up with evolving technologies.